Microphone check. Let's get it popping, man.
Yo, he got a lot of excitement. This is energy.
Man, yo. What?
Jay feeling good right now.
Hey, man, we didn't, did we miss a week? No, we didn't.
Yeah, we did.
Did we?
Yeah.
We missed a week?
Yeah.
Why? We missed a week?
We missed a week.
All right, bet. I thought, because I know we
missed last week.
All right, bet. So we didn't miss a week.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, man.
Audio for the last joint didn't go up yet, so.
The audio went up. It's just the video didn't.
I mean, the video didn't. Right.
Yeah, so.
I'm praying that comes around one day.
Yeah.
That was a phenomenal episode, by the way.
It was a great episode.
Yeah. Right.
So, we missed a week. We back right now.
Yeah.
Full effect. Y'all might not like this podcast. Episode 008.
Yes.
Hey, you killing me with the fucking earphones under the bucket hat, bro. We gotta be better. Come on, we gotta be better than that.
Nah,
man.
Nigga, I spent money on this hat. I'm definitely wearing this motherfucker.
Gotta wear it.
I bought it specifically for the pod.
It's not the hat. It's the fucking earphones underneath it.
But I'm in my audio engineer mode.
Yeah,
right? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
I'm in my engineer mode.
All right, man. Whatever, man. We got special guests in the building today, tonight, however you want to call it.
Yeah.
Mr. Bankshot is here.
Hey, we in this thing, man. We in this thing. Thank you. I appreciate y'all for having me.
Nah,
here,
yo, I appreciate you for coming,
bro. I told you I was coming through, man. You know what I mean? Like, this was already in the making. About a month in the making, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate you for pulling up.
We like two chicks that's been broken, that been left hanging multiple times, so we just so appreciative of you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Damn, it'd be like that.
Because other people done said they was going to show love and then didn't.
But I ain't going to do my guy like that. Not this one.
Oh, y'all was talking. I thought y'all was talking in general.
Oh no, we was talking did us.
Oh,
but dang. I ain't gonna do this one like that.
Okay,
not
that's him. What's up.
Okay,
because he show love.
Yeah, yeah.
This is maybe a miscommunication.
Okay.
I don't like that he put it on me, but I'm gonna tell him.
Okay,
we friends. Like, we friends.
That's cool.
Yeah, so we can do that. Shit. So, but my God, Bankshot is in the building.
I am. Nah. I'm in the building, man.
Hey, let's do something real quick.
Because
JS1 the supplier.
That's me,
Mr. J Hill.
Yeah, you.
Jay said he told me about this last week. Well, 2 weeks ago. He was like, man, I heard Bel Air coming out with some cognac.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I never knew about it.
Bel Air got a cognac?
Yeah, so.
That's that bottle.
Ah.
That's that
so
villain.
This is actually Villon.
Oh, shit.
Oh, Villon.
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 Okay, thank
like
you.
Like,
Villon, France.
Know. Like a villain from
yes.
France.
Yes, it's spelled villain, but it's pronounced Villon. So it's a VSOP XO cognac blend finished with French wheat. What is it? Residential.
There you go. They made it in the house.
It's not residential.
It's residential
no,
cognac.
It's not residential.
Residual
sugars. I got tongue twisted. I just knew it wasn't what I was saying.
Nah. I like that. I thought this was some hood. This is hood cognac.
Community cognac.
Yeah.
It's a VSOP XO cognac blend finished with French wheat. It's residual sugars. Yeah, man. It's a liqueur.
A liqueur.
I thought it was a full cognac.
Yeah.
So it's not a cognac. Is it liqueur? You don't like
cognac?
Grand Marnier?
I don't like Grand Marnier.
Grand Marnier is amazing.
I used to love it when I was young, but now that I'm an older dude and I've tasted so many different things, I moved away from that.
Yeah.
So it has some hints of. Let me see.
When you're trying to break a girl into the cognac world, you started with that. That's when you get them some Grand Marnier.
Oh,
because you know women like
good,
a lot of sweeter stuff. So like you give them the experience of the oaky flavor of the cognac with the sweetness, and then you can bring in something like
so
that.
So it got some hints of orange, vanilla, and cinnamon. Let's see if we can taste it.
Let's go.
Let's taste it. Let's pop this.
That.
Shout out to Bel Air, the Bel Air family.
Yeah.
We got Black Bottle Boys in the building, Bamboo in the building.
Yeah.
We got some motherfucking McQueen. That McQueen was good.
That shit was fire.
What the fuck is McQueen?
We was lit that day.
It's gin.
Yeah.
But it doesn't taste like gin.
It don't taste like gin. And I don't, it didn't give me the after effects of gin that I've had before.
Are y'all alcoholics?
Yes.
I'm not. I just like free shit. That's it.
That's a fact too. I fuck with that shit too.
But yo, let's pull up a shot first. Let's have a conversation. Let's get into this conversation.
Okay,
man.
Okay.
You pour your own poison, dog.
Why? Where you going?
Let's I want to get straight into this conversation.
All right, let's do it.
Speaking of free shit, right?
Oh shit.
Yo, when do we get to the when is it at the point where it's not free, right? It's business, right? Because
right,
now, like, I remember at one point, both of our careers, I would assume, and of course yours as well.
Yeah.
Where people will offer free stuff and will want you to, like, wear it or promote it.
Absolutely.
And thinking it was good enough because it was free.
Yeah.
It's like, nah, now you
got to
pay
as well. A lot of that shit be trash,
though.
But a lot of the shit that you get be trash. Like, I'm just going to say that, like, as black people gotta do a little better, man.
Okay.
You know,
that's
we can't
fact.
Just we can't just put out anything. And we can't be hitting up motherfuckers like, hey, I want you to wear this shit in on your platform and me sending it to you is enough compensation.
No.
It's not.
No way near.
It's not. I need some digits on top of that. You know what I mean? Because I'm putting it out there for the people. And they might buy it and then, you know.
I feel like, in my opinion, I feel like compensation is a necessity until your brand adds to the validity of my show. So, like, if your company is big enough that when you sending me that, I'm cool and not, you know what I mean, and it helps the perception of me in the show,
absolutely.
Then it makes a difference.
Absolutely.
But if you are upstart and you trying to generate sales off of my views,
my platform,
you know what I mean, and you really, that's a big thing for you,
that's the difference.
You need to go ahead and kick me some dollars.
Well, when does that change, though? Because I remember, like I said, at all of our first career, it was dope to get some free shit and rock it.
Right,
yeah, absolutely.
But when did it change, I guess? When
your numbers started getting serious and your overhead started getting serious.
Okay.
So, you know, when we first started out, shit, we only had like one or two cameras. Now you like four or five cameras in, mixers, you know what I'm saying? Shoot, the damn cables cost $30 a watt.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a fact.
For Facts. Real. And then the time that we spent editing and all this other stuff like that. So then people got to understand that, bro. Yeah. Like, yo, if you want to get in a mix of what's costing us hundreds of dollars every week, yo, come on, help me offset those costs. Like, let's just be real about it.
No,
how y'all like it, man?
Yeah,
this
is pretty good.
I taste heavy cinnamon.
Oh, yeah, this shit got a little kick to it, yeah.
This is definitely liqueur vibe.
Oh, my God, yeah. That shit got a little like...
There's definitely some liqueur vibes.
Yeah, they got like some fireball in that motherfucker.
Yeah,
that shit is,
definitely fireball.
Yeah, shit.
Yo, I didn't even think about that.
Yo, did you watch the Kanye shit?
You know what's so funny, bro? I didn't even know he was doing a listening party in Atlanta.
Yo, you know what's crazy? Because I
didn't even know about the listening party.
It was 30,000 people that did.
50,000 people went.
50,000 people
This nigga was charging $50 for chicken tenders.
I don't think that was him, though. I see a lot of people talking about it. I don't think that was him, bro.
I think that was, like, I agree with him. It's the vendors going, yeah, Kanye coming.
Kanye would charge 50.
Yeah, I might as well just up my price because he can get away with it.
But he rented it out, right?
Yeah, but you can't, you know, the vendors, they pay for those slots to sell product.
Right.
So, like, you know what I'm saying? So they get to set their own prices for their product. It's not a normal basketball game. It's Kanye, my nigga.
Let me
ask
you this. If you paying $50 for chicken tenders, how many chicken tenders you expect to give?
Hey.
50.
You should have 50 chicken tenders then?
Yo, like,
shit.
I need at least
you gonna get a smooth four. All right.
Let me do it like this. Honestly, all right. If I'm paying $50 at a spot like that, At least give me 10 tickets.
At least 10, right?
Yeah.
But fries.
Or, you know what? Matter of fact, I'm going to take it back. I'm going to go out on a limb with this, and I know y'all going to hate me for this.
Please
give me 5.
5?
Well, I'm going to say 5 because...
What, $10 a tender?
And give me complimentary fries.
Let me tell you something. If I spend $50 on that and you haggle about giving me an extra dip... We fighting. I'm jumping over the table.
That part.
I'm jumping over the table.
You probably don't even get no dips.
Nigga. What you talking about? You better dip me up out this motherfucker.
I hate when I go to a fucking restaurant and I be like, yo, can I get another sauce? But you give me one sauce. I got all this fucking food. I can't get you 35 cents.
I like to dip my sandwiches, everything into dips.
So right, talking about like, 35 cents for a fucking dip. You suck my dick.
I'm the same way.
Chick-fil-A don't do you like that, though. Chick-fil-A give you all the sauces you want.
Yeah, no, they look out.
That's
they
be like, how many?
Because they done taxed you out the gate, nigga. They done taxed you. You done
Chick-fil-A's
sat there.
Common prices, you know what I mean?
It's not common prices.
You think it's expensive?
Nah, Chick-fil-A's cool.
I think it's high-end fast food.
It's high-end chicken.
Where you from, bro?
I'm from Ohio.
Ohio.
City called Elyria. It's like 40 minutes from Cleveland.
Oh, shit. Okay. You in a different world, huh?
So you grew up a big fan of LeBron?
No. I was a Kobe fan.
Okay.
Big
okay.
Kobe fan. R.I.P. Kobe. But once he retired, I kind of started to like...
Transition.
Appreciate his greatness. You know what I mean? Like, I went to the parade and shit when they won in Cleveland. You know what I mean? That shit was motherfucking... Hey.
How big of a superstar is LeBron, though? Like, in Cleveland? Ohio in general.
He left. I don't think they like him no more.
No, they love him, man.
They still love him?
Well, he's a... Bro,
they
he's
brought he brought a championship to a city that ain't had one in 50 years. You feel me? So it's like...
He's like a superstar.
Like, he's like the...
But I heard y'all damn near burned the city down the first time he left.
The first time he left, yes. Because this nigga went on fucking TV and told the world, you know what I mean? Like, niggas ain't know what the fuck he's about to do. But hey, I'm taking my talents to South Beach. And fuck y'all niggas. Like, damn, like, nigga, you could have just did it in your comfort of your home. But we knew that he was going to bang out eventually when his contract was up anyway, though. And it's like, you brought us a championship, so it's like, nigga, hey, you can leave. You know what I mean? It's like, if a bitch come through, she don't fuck you, but she suck your dick. You get a nut.
I appreciate that.
You did your job. Now you can go.
I ain't mad at
much
that.
Respect. You feel me? Much like, respect on that. Yeah.
I don't want you to stay. You know what I mean? Like, you did what you're supposed to do.
Thank you.
I'm cool with that.
Go do your thing. You know what I mean? So we can get somebody else up in here.
You know what I mean? So, yo, like, first of all, I was wanted to ask y'all because we skipped this.
Okay.
Did y'all like the project on Kanye West?
I didn't listen to that shit.
Yeah,
only thing I heard was the whole verse, and as much as the excitement of the moment was there, I was like, this is not the best whole verse
I've ever heard. I didn't hear shit.
Damn.
Yeah.
So we can't even have that conversation.
I'm out of touch with music.
I knew you was gonna be locked into every second of this shit.
I mean,
was such a Kanye stan. No, he don't like. He loves.
Oh, that's your favorite.
That's that nigga right there. You
like
know
Kanye
what
West is Gemini. I'm a Gemini for like you know like.
That has nothing to do with anything.
It got a lot to do with everything.
Like so you like him because he's a Gemini.
I feel like we can relate on a lot. Mm. I feel like, and we can relate on a lot because of our signs. I feel like we are similar.
You had
in
your
a lot
jaw
of ways.
Wired before.
Nah, I never had my jaw wired cars, but I pray I have
it. That's a pause moment.
I mean, everything is a pause.
No, that's facts. Though. You got some pause on everything.
Yeah. Now, I feel like I will hope my jaw would never be wired, but I just feel like, you know, when it comes to being misunderstood, I feel like a lot of things I can understand the way he speak. You know what I'm saying? I feel like, for me, Kanye West, you know, it started in the beginning, and it's kind of like, this might sound weird, it's kind of like being an Eagles fan for me. Because once we won that Super Bowl, everybody thought I jumped on a bandwagon, right? So for Kanye West, it's like, now he's being successful. It's like, people think I'm jumping on a bandwagon. But it's like, bro, when he first started making music, he was trying to plead to Jay-Z, like, y'all can be a rapper. He, like, keep making beats, right? Dame Dash put a battery in his back, right? And he always said I could be a good rapper. And he was a good rapper, right? He got into it with Nike, making the Yeezys then, right? The Red Octobers and things like that. They said he wasn't a designer. Now look at Yeezy now, right? I vividly remember the conversation he was having with Charlamagne and DJ Envy on the Breakfast Club. And Charlamagne's like, bro, you got rich people problems. He's like, nah, bro. Like, I want to be a billionaire. Like, this ain't it, right? And Charlamagne was like, you're wildin', right? Now look at him, he's a billionaire. Everything, I feel like everything, he was always ahead of his time. And at that moment, at those moments, people couldn't understand him. He was always like just a... I forgot the word, but like not a futurist. I forgot.
Visionary.
Yeah, visionary.
A visionary, right? Yeah. I call myself a visionary. Like, I remember.
Got it.
I used to call myself a creative, but like now I just call myself a visionary.
So if he offers us a podcast deal on his label, we not taking it. Or we taking the deal?
Why wouldn't we take it?
I don't know.
You see it bigger.
You a visionary. So I'm thinking, you ain't one trying to be up underneath of him. You trying to get your own Billy.
You trying to niggas up underneath you.
Wait. Let's not get it fucked up.
Hold on. Let me handclap for that one.
I think what happens is, honestly, a lot of niggas just don't understand the game. Like, for me, I'm a visionary and I'm a creative at the same time, right?
Mm-hmm.
So if I create some shit, I'm going to create some more shit. Honestly, so if Kanye West like, yo, put this up underneath my platform, cool. Put this under your platform and guess what I'm doing tomorrow? Creating something else that go right under my platform because they're going to go to his platform, see me, come right back to my platform. It is what it is. Like, I ain't tripping. Like, I just feel like you got...
Okay.
Jay Hill got the game.
Yeah.
You got the game. What's up, man? How you feeling? You the superstar, dog.
Bro, I am...
Yo, you do got the real nice felt beard over there, bro.
Hey, thanks, man. You know what I mean?
It's glistening in the light.
Thanks, man. Shout out to Uncle Jimmy Products, man.
Let's go.
Black-owned business, you know what I mean?
Let's go.
They take care of
they
my
ain't paying
man.
Us over this motherfucker.
I can get y'all some products.
Didn't we just talk about this?
I appreciate that.
It's
okay though, man. You know what I mean?
Like, I mean, they can't put that in there.
Is this shit growing?
You got that though. You know what I mean? You know what I would do to have that? I ain't had hair since 2009.
I feel like we can switch.
Nah, man, you don't want.
If I can have a beard with a ball, you tripping. Girls love a ball head with a beard.
They do.
Yo, you
they
tripping
do.
Though because the waves and the spinning.
The waves
and
is cool.
And the baby face. Like, you going to look
saying,
young.
Like,
you going to look young forever,
yeah.
Nigga.
Beard and a ball head.
Nah, nigga.
Thank
you.
Man.
You TV ready. You movie ready.
A lot of deals, bro, require you to be like clean shaven.
Facts.
Ooh. Like commercials and shit.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's why you ain't never seen a nigga like me in a commercial. Because, nigga, I need.
Unless it's a black company, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right. You know what I mean? Like. That's how I be. A lot
Yo,
before you.
But you is doing a lot of great shit, bro.
Hey, man, I appreciate you,
like,
man.
You've been on fire for a long-ass time,
man.
Bro.
It's just all about being consistent, man. Like, it's this game, man, you got to just stay afloat. You know what I mean? You go through your seasons, you know what I mean? But just don't drown. You feel me?
I said we was going to do an interview, but I'm sorry. I
good, because I have 1,000 questions. So
man,
go
ask,
ahead, kick it up.
Yeah,
away,
so
man.
I'm just saying, like, bro, like, where did it start at?
So, shit, man. 2013, I graduated, quote unquote, man. I graduated college and I moved to Columbus, Ohio. And I was just always like, do like funny shit. I don't know. Like, I've always just been like a funny nigga. So I would like just put videos on Instagram. I'm working at Verizon Wireless Call Center at the time. So like on my lunch break or like my little 15-minute break, I go in the break room, record some shit, blah, blah, blah. And the shit just started taking off. So the, like the first shit that kind of got me popping off was when T-Boz from TLC had reposted this video that I did. And that was like the first moment I'm like, oh, like just keep going with this shit. You know what I mean? But like I said, I started in 2013, but I ain't go like viral to 2016. Like I did some shit. I did like a Casper Slide parody. You know what I mean? And it was called the Steal Your Man Slide. It was like a tutorial on how bitches can steal another bitch's man.
Right.
But that shit was on Shade Room, Baller Alert, nigga, Ricky Smiley Morning Show, like everywhere. So that was like my big break. And then
how many views did that do?
Nigga, that shit, Facebook had like 20 million, bro.
Okay.
Mm.
Yeah, it was like ridiculous. Like
that's super deep.
Ridiculous, you know what I mean?
This nigga like, said 20 million.
I'm over 20 million, you know what I mean?
Hype about my 2 million.
That's a lot, though.
Yo, it's that casual.
I'm just
20 million.
Million. But like, 2 million is still a lot, nigga.
Yeah, that's, I mean, that's a lot. You know what I mean? What's that? That's like
double. And you're not even a funny nigga.
I mean, you're funny as hell.
Nah, I ain't funny.
Yo, you be funny.
I be trying. I ain't funny.
You be unintentionally funny, like, but you don't set out to be funny.
That's the funniest shit, though. Unintentionally funny shit. Right, right, the funniest shit, yeah.
So then, like, how many followers you think you got off of that shit?
Oh, man. My shit went from, I mean, not a lot. Maybe like 100,000. You feel me?
Not a lot.
Not a lot.
Bro, get the fuck out of here, man.
I'm going to break this down, bro. I've been doing this shit, bro, since 2013. We in 2021. So that's 8 years of just consistently just grinding, putting shit out there, right? I'm at like 530,000 on Instagram.
I'm at like 500. Man, get the fuck.
But
I got 2,500. Can you shout me out so I can get some followers?
Absolutely.
I appreciate that.
Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying?
In my head, though, I should be at 1 million. But there's a lot of censorship going on. Shadow ban is a thing. I don't know if y'all hip to that shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, they trying to clean things up more.
They're trying to clean shit up. They just came out with a feature. If you go on your Instagram, right, and go to your settings, hit account, it's some shit called like limited something access. It's pretty much like they prevent you from seeing shit that might offend you.
Wow.
You got to go in and turn that shit off.
Instagram can suck my dick.
Yeah, no, IG definitely can suck my dick.
Fuck out of here. Like, what are we talking about?
So,
yo, do you think it's, because we have, are we going to drink? Come on, let's drink.
I've been drinking.
We've been sitting.
Y'all ain't finished. Let's finish.
Oh, we got to finish it. Oh, man.
I will not be
we don't gotta finish, but let's just drink.
I will not be peer pressured.
Man, I don't know why I let people do that, man.
No, who? I don't know why. First of all, do you get offended by people calling you an Instagram comedian?
No.
All right.
I'd rather that than
not at all.
Not shit. You feel me?
Do you think you're an Instagram comedian?
I consider myself to be a influencer.
Okay.
/ entertainer though.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like, I didn't do stand up at first. When I moved to Atlanta, I got introduced to the stand-up game, you know what I mean? It's a couple of niggas I really fuck with. Ronnie Jordan, Tyler Chronicles, Kamal, and this dude named Remo. They put me on stand-up pretty much like, you gotta do
man,
it.
Man, who is the most unfunny nigga on Instagram right now, you think?
The most unfunniest nigga on Instagram
That's lit, though.
That's lit. Ooh, fuck. Nigga who not funny that everybody
yo, this
think
nigga
is
trying
funny.
To start internet beef. Like,
no.
I'm really sitting here and I'm like, yo. All right, go ahead, do it.
I'm trying to think, man. Who is not
funny? I respect
funny?
You so much if you actually name
he
the name.
He said it.
Bro.
He literally said, I'm here for the shit. So let's get it.
Yeah, I'm trying to see, man. Fuck. It's a lot of
few niggas that's unfunny as fuck, but I don't be understanding why people like that.
Like who? Like,
yeah.
It used to be Country Wayne, but I be seeing it be hit and miss with him. Sometimes he'll do some shit that'll be super funny, but then he'll have some dumb lame
for
shit.
Me, I think
like, I fuck with his stand up, bro. He cold on
his stand up.
I haven't seen his stand up yet. Is cold.
Yeah.
I heard his stand up is cold.
I think he's a stand up. He's a stand up comedian who just started to do
Instagram.
Yeah.
Like to my Instagram. Yeah.
I thought it was the other way around.
Yeah.
I thought
he adapted.
It's a couple niggas like that you would think started on.
I heard niggas is like that.
Yeah,
I heard niggas is like that.
It was a beef when that shit all started. Like, bro, like stand up.
You know, niggas say,
oh no. I know that because stand up is a cultish.
Yeah.
The people that are really in, they have it's a culture.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like they have certain places they be at.
Yeah.
They got certain cliques and groups and shit like that. That's just
me
been
personally.
Like that.
You know who I think is funny?
Who?
Stand up wise, B. Simone.
Move right
I
along.
Think so.
Anyway, all right, back
you
to
think,
you.
Well, you don't think she's funny?
Right. Okay, I got you.
No, man. I'm serious.
You trying to hit? I get it, bro. Yeah, she's great. That, she's wonderful.
Like,
might
be what it
I'm
is.
Not trying to hit nothing.
Because you know she got a, she had a crush on the baby, and you kind of
look like the baby a little bit. So I'm telling you,
I see it. I see what you're doing.
I see
what
you're
doing. Nothing like that.
Yo, shout out to B. Simone, yo.
No, I'm not.
You are really funny.
I fuck with B. Simone. We done a couple shows together.
Nah, because what happened was, I was cool. I'm cool with, like, Desi. Desi is cool, right?
Yeah.
So I remember them coming to Baltimore doing something at the Chocolate Factory or some shit like that.
Yeah.
And she held it down. Mm. I thought she was funny. Mm. I thought she was really funny. Mm. Yeah. Come quiet, bro.
Yo, I'm just listening to you, sir.
What happened this week,
bro? I'm allowing you to, you already know what happened this week. I'm not getting into it. So we're going to move on. Hey, maybe we're talking about B. Simone. So let's get back into the comedy. You were saying that there's a big disconnect between stand-up comedians.
Yeah, and niggas on the internet.
Yeah,
and
niggas on the internet.
Big-ass beef. Man, you know what's so funny, bro? I had this idea.
Has the beef been settled? Have y'all started to mend, or is it still like...
It's been settled because stand-up niggas realize that they need social media.
Damn. Like,
you have to do, and if COVID ain't teach niggas that you need social media, then nigga, that you need social media. So I think that shit kind of like.
What about a nigga, shit, he got like mad followers. He's a comedian. His content look really like good.
Ooh.
Shit. He got like a lot of followers, like millions of followers. I don't know if he's based in LA or something.
Why are you thinking about that? I was going to say that. The problem, now when I talked to some professional comedians and we was having like a closed door conversation about the situation, they were saying that it sucks for them to have to now put their content that they talk about on stage on camera because now it gets put more work on them. They could really develop an hour show and work that hour for 3-4 years.
Yeah, no, facts.
You know, around the country.
But it's the same thing with DJ and the host, bro. So like, it's some DJs that's in the area, right? And like, if you listen to them, they got the same entire set. What I will say is, if you continuing to get a new audience, that shit is dope.
Yeah. But right? You're not getting the same audience.
Yeah, but if you're not getting the same audience, Instagram. Right? But what happens with Instagram, you can get a new follower, but your old followers getting
it's
tired.
Still coming
of that
through.
Shit.
Right.
It's like, yo, what the fuck? I'm tired of this shit.
Yeah, I'm tired of that shit. That's funny to think about, though, because you know, like, if it's your favorite song, like, you'll listen to that shit, like,
Forever.
You know what I mean? But like, I can't come back with the same skit or content because y'all niggas want the new shit.
It depends on how it's structured and how it's put together. Like, if it's like some call and response shit, you know what I mean? It could be recycled over and over. Or like certain things that we love to hear that story, you know, you can kind of get away with it. But the one-off, one-liners and stuff like that may get old.
And I think it depends on when you do it, right? For example, let's go to a song. Let's say Birthday Chick, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Or not any birthday song, but the right birthday songs, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like what happens is it's not really old because it's always special to somebody in that given moment.
Right.
Right? Because it's always somebody's birthday.
You know what, man? How come ain't no birthday song for niggas, though? You ain't never heard a birthday song for
niggas. You just hit.
One time for your birthday?
Yo, I feel. Stop.
One time for the birthday, bitch. That's what.
No. But I was like, what's the nigga?
And then you got go
song. The club song?
It's your birthday.
No. The club joint?
What's the nigga now, man? He run with Dolphin, though, man. He used to run with Moneybag. Yo, what the fuck is the nigga name, man? Black Youngster.
Black Youngster.
When you want down your birthday?
He not with.
Gang Gang. That's a nigga birthday song?
That's not really a birthday.
Ghost.
You
out on that. 50 Cent. It's your birthday.
Go Shawty.
You going party.
Like, Shawty. It's your birthday.
And you know, like, we don't give a fuck. It's not your birthday.
You a Shawty?
You can find me in the club.
Jay Hill's a Shawty. All right.
Shout out to Jay Hill being a Shawty.
I ain't no Shawty.
Go ahead, Shawty.
What I was going to say is the nigga King Botch.
Got you.
I don't think he's funny at all.
He's kind of funny, though.
He's not funny.
He's funny on like a Will Ferrell level, though.
He's funny on a white person level. Yeah.
Will Ferrell. He's funny, and the girls want to look at him because he keep taking his shirt off.
That's not funny.
Not funny.
Well, he's not making it for you.
His content is A1.
Content A fucking
his shit is different,
bro. He right now he probably just put shit out just to do it, bro. He got millions, bro. He on Netflix and shit. You feel me? Like, nigga, he ain't got a motherfucker.
Well, it's like you built a brand, like a product, and you just got to keep serving
that's
that
it.
Audience. That's
man,
all
that's
you
it,
doing.
Man.
While he's trying to get roles in movies and television shows and develop new shit, but I fuck with that shit. But I would say that when I was having a discussion about the comedians doing stand up, I was like, the reason why I feel like certain comedians never make it past a certain point, publicity wise, is they became lazy. Like, you gotta create content.
You
like,
got to.
Young dudes like, y'all gonna make it in Hollywood so quick because y'all can develop an idea, get an idea, develop it, and get it out there and get it going. ASAP. And that's what Hollywood wants. They want to find people. I'm gonna give you a bag. How many movies you gonna give me?
Yo, yeah, I got a question, bro.
Go ahead.
I wanted to have this conversation so bad for some reason. It's weird.
Okay.
Speaking of, like, just being a comedian, right? Do you feel like sometimes you're not taking as serious as you want to be taken?
Perhaps.
Nah. You mean, do you feel, I'm going to ask you this question. Are you talking about the content isn't being taken serious, or you feeling like him as a businessman and a creative being taken seriously? Not even a businessman,
but like as a person in general, like somebody trying to take you serious because they always look at you and want to laugh.
Yeah, no, that's, no, facts. Like, niggas will walk up to me and just start laughing just off GP. And like, I know it's, you know, might be hard to believe, but like, I got bars, nigga.
Wait, so what?
I got bars. Like, I have bars.
Wait a minute. No, are you doing this to be funny?
But listen, though, like, not on some, like, I can get on here and do a Sway freestyle type shit, but like, if you pay attention to how I, like, write out my shit, like, I have bars. So if I wanted to put out, like, a legit rap album, niggas ain't gonna take it serious, bro. They gonna be listening for, like, the funny shit, or if I say some real shit.
I feel like you should get on some mad villain shit.
I ain't gonna lie to you,
just dog. Wear a mask or something, and then don't even, yeah.
It's V-Lone.
Like, V-Lone shit. Mask V-Lone shit.
You know what I mean?
All I'm saying is, I ain't gonna lie, I appreciate you for fucking with me and pulling up, but I ain't gonna take it serious either.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you're not gonna listen to this shit. Like, if I wanted to, like, you know, Kanye. Let's go back to Kanye. Kanye started doing gospel, right? It's like, damn.
I don't listen to Kanye gospel.
But you a Kanye fan, though.
I love Kanye. And I was like, if y'all listen to the fucking project, I was going to be the first one to say that I don't like it.
But you didn't listen to it. How you
going to not listen to it?
He said you listened to the gospel.
Yeah, the new project that just came out.
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the gospel album.
I was going to talk about the new project.
I knew you was going to love it, bro.
No, I didn't like it. Mace was rapping.
He went to God. He went back to the streets. It's like, bro, I can't.
Niggas be confused.
They do be confused, man. They be confused. You know what I mean? Like,
did he have the lead singer of U2 on fucking one of them records? The one he did with Jay-Z?
Kanye?
Yeah, yo.
I wouldn't put it past
that. That's some super pop star shit.
I wanted to talk to you about this. This is the conversation I want to talk to you. So you was fortunate enough to be raised with both of your parents.
Facts.
What about you?
Shout out to both of the parents. No, unfortunately, I was not.
You was just raised with your pops or your moms?
My grandma raised me.
Your grandma raised you?
Well, you different. Grandma raising you is a different level.
It's a different level.
I want to ask you a question, though. I want to ask, because I'm curious to hear your answer to this.
Yes.
Do you believe that you have bitch tendencies?
Yo, this conversation just got serious.
That did get serious, man.
Let me pull up to the mic. Gee, you know, woo.
Ain't no telling who all gonna see this. So, like, I really want my answer to be no.
What you talking about?
If I'm gonna be honest, though, it's like, I feel like I have my quote-unquote, like, period moments.
Mm. Now, are you meaning that you in touch with your feelings, or are you saying you have a tendency to be in your feelings?
Both. I think both. So I asked this
pastor?
Question.
Nah, stop.
I asked this question because, you know, I feel like a lot of niggas are bitch made because they're raised by a woman. And this is no disrespect to a woman. We talking amongst men. I feel like a lot of times what happened is what separate them from the quote unquote real men, right? Because I ain't gonna say real niggas is the fact that a real man is able to acknowledge it. Mm. Right? Because I feel like, because what happens, I was raised by just my moms. So of course I'm gonna have a little bitch tendencies, honestly, if that makes sense, because I was raised by a woman. I'm around women all
like
the time.
That,
the funniest part is there's
nigga,
a woman off camera
up.
And her face is insane right now. She's like, because
you low key are saying, and no disrespect, but you're saying that your mom was a B word.
Nah, but bro, I'm saying because first of all,
that's not what
like my
saying.
Man Star like, said. Like my man Star said, we're amongst men. Like. That's how we talk. They call us niggas all the time.
Facts.
All I'm saying is, let's eliminate the word. So let's say woman ways, right?
Okay.
Because like, y'all want to be so politically correct. We amongst
I'm
men
not saying
having
we
a conversation.
Be correct.
All
I was
I'm
just
saying,
saying is, the shorty was trying to die over in the corner. And it was funny.
So what I'm saying is, I feel like a lot of niggas be having female ways.
Absolutely.
But that's because it was raised by a woman. But once you tell a nigga, you got all these female ways, they get offended.
They ready to fight.
Absolutely.
They
want to
fight.
Because they don't see that, though. They don't see it as they got female ways. They just think that's how they is, you know?
And for clarification purposes, for those at home who are listening and the women who have got offended but still, for some reason, haven't tuned out, Like
for some reason,
female tendencies first, meaning that you have a tendency to move off emotion. Like you're in an emotional moment and you allow that to dominate your decision.
See, now I feel like why can't men have emotions? Why does it got to be labeled as like?
Because historically, it has been taught to men to ignore their emotions or suppress their emotions,
right, right.
versus embrace them.
I feel like now it's like kind of like cool for men to kind of like tap into their feelings
because we've discovered that.
I don't think it's cool.
No. What you're saying,
girls
you
ain't
say,
letting it rock these days.
Depending on what girl you fucking
hold
with.
Hold on. Depending on what bitch you fucking with. Excuse me, girl. But what I'm trying to is that being.
Bitches.
What we've.
Bitches, nigga.
These hoes. But the point I was trying to make
niggas
is.
Niggas ain't shit.
Niggas ain't never been shit. Is that you need to start recognizing what your feelings are so that you can, first of all, deal with it. Because sometimes, like, you just got a bunch of shit. You might need to just talk about it so you can let it go. So it doesn't affect your decision-making, how your outlook on life is, who you deal with, how you deal with them. But the thing is, back 20, 30, 40, 50 years ago, nigga, that we didn't know that we needed to do that.
Right.
No, the only thing we knew was be straight-faced, don't cry, because you don't want to show weakness. It was all about not showing weakness.
Though, Jay, like, I think, you know, the thing about it is, it's nothing, first of all.
Yeah, I'm going to need some of that, too.
It's nothing wrong with having feminine ways at all.
Exactly.
I think, you know, we talk about the way of the superior man. We both,
right.
We have masculine and feminine ways, just like women have masculine and feminine ways.
You are correct.
It is what it is. All I'm saying is I feel like,
see, most women with masculine ways though are studs.
That's not true.
I feel like
that's
what
not
you
true. Like,
what you didn't get
example,
is go ahead.
For example, I'm sorry, I gotta be this guy. In the way of the superior man, right? They say a masculine way, for example, is trying to solve a problem.
Right.
That's a masculine way.
Correct.
That's masculine.
Wow.
That's, yeah, okay. that's a masculine trait.
Wow.
Right, so it's nothing wrong with you having feminine ways, just like it's nothing wrong with a woman having masculine ways.
Yeah.
Right?
I mean, like, I owned up to it. I said, you know.
But I do think when we talk about this world, like this world full of like men and how we should be, right? Mm. I feel like a lot of niggas is bitch made because they bitch made.
No, that's facts though. I'm gonna get kind of deep.
I'm sorry.
I don't mean to get
that
deep.
That was a half explanation.
No, it definitely
I'm
was.
Saying they
it
bitch
was.
Made because it was raised
it
by
was.
A woman.
I
so.
Thought you were gonna take us somewhere.
I ain't sorry,
like,
about that.
You know, but. So my situation is so my mom was murdered by my pops.
Oh wow!
Yowzers.
When I was seven.
Wow.
Yeah.
That is not funny at all.
Not funny at all. You know what I mean? Not funny at all. This is y'all should take me serious at this moment. You feel me? But so being raised by my grandparents, my grandma, like that situation was never discussed. Like
right.
We never had that conversation. So like when I became an adult, that's when I had to like kind of sit back and like. Reflect on that situation and kind of like analyze, like, damn, like, how does this affect me? Like, when it comes to just relationships with women or just like with my niggas, you know what I mean? Like, you have to, in order to really like kind of like get into your feelings, you got to really like sit down and
you got to acknowledge it.
You got to acknowledge it, you know what I mean? At first, I thought, like, you know, if let's say I break up with somebody, right? I'm gonna go look for the next bitch to help me get over that situation, but I'm not really.
The best way to solve a problem is to recognize it first. You got to recognize
it.
You got to
recognize it. You know what I mean?
Like, because I understand, like, in a, like as we joke or whatever, like, my mom's was raped. That's how she had me, right? Mm. So I feel like, for me, that's dope. You know what I'm saying? Like, but no. At the same time, I was so caught up in the fact that it was dope that I never really dealt with it, right? Mm. I never really, like, how does that make you feel?
Yeah.
And even in the conversation, it might sound like we joking. It's nothing, but again, I just feel like if we can embrace that, yo, I might got some bitch ways. You feel me? Like, it is.
Yeah.
But like, and again, female ways for
right,
to be
right.
Political.
Yeah, no,
I'm not having
worried.
A conversation among
yeah,
men.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm saying I'm not worried about.
But what happens is, and this is what this is the conversation I want to have is, it's really on us to be in our children's lives, because what happened is, if you're just raised by a woman, all you know is what a woman think. Just to be
right,
honest, because
right.
You don't have any male, counterparts or
yeah.
Male figures in your life. Because right. What happens is now all you know is. How your mom told you to solve a problem.
Yeah.
So now you're going to solve a problem how your mom's told you to
yeah.
Solve a problem, not how
yeah.
Your father told you how to solve a problem because your father wasn't there. So I don't want to be ignorant and say you got bitch made ways because you bitch made. But at the same time, that's my way of joking about it, but being real at the same time because, like, y'all understand that, bro. All I can do, even in a relationship, like we fast forwarding, right? In our relationship amongst our woman, we're going to respond in a way that we know how to. Because when we was raised by our moms, all we got was, I can't speak for you, but yelling at me, right?
Oh, yeah.
Telling
me
this ain't right, or I need the man to fuck up, or et cetera, et cetera. So now that I'm in a relationship, I'm only giving you what I got, right? I didn't have a male figure in my life to say, hey, do this, do that,
yeah,
right? And that's why it's important for us not to have that to be an excuse, but for us to learn.
So how do you learn how to become a man?
You learn. So for me, I was fortunate enough to play sports, and I had a lot of male figures in my life. Like, I'm just to be honest, I was fortunate. I would never say, like, I never had nobody was there. I would never say that. I had a lot of male figures in my life, and I feel like I've learned how to be a man just through them. Right? Mm-hmm. I've learned how to be a man through the positive men in my life, and the guys that was like, you know, like, you aren't supposed to do this, right? Right. Man is about character. Man is about, and I put a lot of it. I definitely want to shout out my moms. I don't give a fuck. Like, she definitely held it down. Like, oh, she gosh. Always told me, like, you know, like, a man is to be character, right? If something goes wrong, you take accountability, right? So, like, I'll never forget, like, and one of my coaches was saying, like, all you got in this world is your name and your word, right? And your word is a part of your name,
hey,
right?
That's so why I had, like, to pull up. I didn't want to.
Yo, you full of shit.
Sorry, I'm talking shit.
Nigga, hey, nah, but that's some real shit, though. Yeah, like, he's joking, but that's some real shit.
I had to pull up, like.
Right.
You feel me?
And that's really all a part of networking and building your brand. Like,
yeah, facts.
He probably got a lot of opportunities because he's been a man of his word. Mm. You know what I mean? And then that word carries, like, yo, that nigga here, he represented for me. Yeah.
What about,
like,
this, though?
Go ahead.
Because I feel like sometimes that good character shit fuck you up.
Yo,
what about,
there's a weight to being an honorable man, bro. There's a weight you carry.
I feel like a lot of the successful men are hated by so many because they had to do what they had to do. And I'm going to ask y'all, I'm going to ask both of y'all.
Yeah.
Where do you draw the line at principle and doing what you got to do?
That's tough, man.
It is.
That's not tough, cool. You throwing me in a fucked up position.
Even like on a lower level, like I done promoted some shit on my platform before that I knew was trash.
Mm.
But it's like, nigga,
I needed the bread.
I needed the bread at that time, you know what I mean? So it's like, damn, I got to put this out to my people.
But is that really a thing? You still, you're just a...
That's not
you're
good
a performer.
It's
like,
a
that has nothing to do with...
It's a commercial.
It's a commercial. It don't have nothing to do with you,
you know
personally.
I mean?
Let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's get a little bit more real. Because you're an actor. You're an entertainer.
Ooh.
Let's get
you're
to
a thespian.
I'm a...
Speaking
pause.
Of that's
no,
not,
I didn't
no,
say
I
no,
know
no.
What
no.
Is, man.
But, but let's go into that. Would you play a gay actor?
Absolutely not.
For real?
So
no. You wouldn't play gay,
you know,
in a movie?
You know,
you
so
wouldn't
funny.
Do 6 degrees
you
of separation?
You know what's so funny, bro, is I've done like a skit where, like, I play like a gay dude. You know what
right,
I mean?
Right.
Like, this nigga, his like, one nigga come to the crib, and the gay nigga is there, and he's like, oh, what up? Like, you trying to play 2K? And he's like, yeah, we can play 2K, and the niggas get to playing the game. And the straight nigga was like,
gay.
Hey, I'm about to bust your ass. And then, like, it cuts to, like, the gay nigga with his pants down. Like, oh,
hey, yo,
to,
that was you
I mean?
With your pants down? You had your pants down?
It was a sense of bar over.
Right,
man.
Right.
You
had
your ass
out there. I had to show the niggas afterwards. But, like, that's funny as you say that, though, but, like, if...
Your DMs was flooded. Was your DMs flooded?
No, it was funny. But it was funny. But, like, are you asking me, do I got to play a gay role where, like, I'm engaging with another nigga?
Yeah.
Fuck no.
So, all right,
fuck
so,
no.
So, but all I asked you that, right? So I said, where do you draw the line, right?
You seen Soul Plane?
Yeah.
Remember the one gay nigga?
Yeah, the fat boy, the fat guy.
He didn't engage in no type of gay act.
Right.
He was just gay.
Right.
Bro,
he's saying,
I mean?
He don't want to be in bed with another man.
Fuck no.
Let me ask you right now. So are you I'm assuming,
straight.
I'm assuming.
But that don't mean.
I'm assuming you
but
don't.
But it's a movie. Nobody's gonna.
I'm assuming
no.
You're doing pretty good in your life then.
I'm doing okay.
So, but you're not struggling.
I have my moment.
His all right,
so
his
that's
struggle
a, let me
is
ask
different
you.
Than our struggle.
Do you have any kids?
No kids. Shout right, out
so
to no kids.
Let me give you a hand
that,
clap for that. That's crazy.
I asked you that because I feel like...
No abortions either.
What? Yeah, never had no abortions.
Never had no abortions.
Damn. Oh, so you ain't out here fucking them raw?
Sometimes.
So no, I actually,
but I gotta like you, though. I gotta
like you. I asked you that because I feel like, yo, at where do you draw the line? Like, all right, it's clearly acting, right? And if this role It's going to give you millions of dollars and change your life.
I'm not kissing no nigga. I'm not in bed with no nigga. I'll play a silly gay role like the nigga from Soul Plane.
But you wouldn't kiss a man for $1 million?
Nigga, no.
Is that not a pride thing?
I think it's a
principle thing for him.
Yeah, it's kind of like a...
And where do you draw the line from principle for reality? Like, that would change your fucking life.
All right, so what if niggas was
kissing a nigga would definitely change my life.
Hold up.
Like, I would get no more pussy.
Look.
I don't want
to. But you'll have a
million dollars. No, that's not true.
You could take care of your family for life.
It'll be completely different. Chicks is going to flood you, period.
But you could take care of your family for life.
First big role in the film, they going to give you $5 million. You ain't got to do a long kiss scene, but you just got to do.
Nigga kiss on
y'all got to do the. You know what I mean? And then hold up, and one more scene. Niggas coming in. The dude.
Pause. Niggas coming in. Pause.
No pause. No pause.
The camera comes in the room. You under the cover with the nigga. That's it.
No.
For $5 million?
I'm trying
to
figure out.
You're going
to
change your fucking family life and your family.
I'm not going to change my family shit because, nigga, y'all not getting none of this. Y'all wasn't in the bed with me.
Yo, no, nigga. You got shorts on. Niggas ain't penetrating you. There's none of that. Y'all barely even touching for real.
Y'all watch Power?
I was about to say some Power.
Power went gay quick. You know what I mean? Like, it went gay quick.
So you wouldn't take $5 million?
No.
Bro, I feel like, I'm going to keep it.
And they didn't get paid $5 million. Let me tell y'all that right now.
So I said, I ain't gonna lie to you. I did all that to say, I probably wouldn't do it either.
Oh, man.
But at the same time.
man, I didn't know what you about to say. You said, look, I ain't gonna lie to you.
You trying to tell me niggas are putting $5 million on the table.
So I'm gonna keep it on
a peck on the lips and some undercover shit. Like,
I'm gonna keep it on it. I feel like niggas are fucking dumb as shit. I feel like, I think this is the world, though. To be honest, I'm going to put myself in that box.
I don't know, man.
Yo, we are so prideful that we won't take one small chance or opportunity to take care of our family because of how we're going to look to the next man. Because I know you're not doing that for yourself. You're doing it because of how the world going to perceive you. You just said, I would never get no pussy. So I don't got shit to do with you.
I mean, me getting pussy has to do a lot with me.
Oh, my God.
That's an important part of living life.
I mean,
sex, it ain't, though.
Like, when you get to a certain age, you kind of like, all right, pussy.
But we ain't nowhere near that age yet. Calm the fuck down.
I mean,
you ain't nowhere near.
I am.
But do you understand what I'm saying?
I'm at a point where it's like, hey.
But do you understand what I'm saying?
Sex ain't really a thing right now?
Sex is
so Holly Berry, welcome on. You want to
keep if we can't connect mentally, I don't.
Oh, now you're sexual.
Shut your ass up. Ain't nobody trying to hear that shit.
Bro, we have to be able to, like, not even on some, bro. Anybody can get a nut, you know what I mean? Like, there's been some women that I fucked where I'd rather have just jacked off. Like, and just got my nut that way. Because it's not like... You got to be into the same
We've all had that.
But now, so I said this again, back to what you're saying. I feel like we are stupid because we're going to pass up generational wealth because of a fucking dumbass feeling that's not even real. Because you're acting. It's entertainment.
I'm saying
myself too.
So where you got to go tonight? Where you got to go?
I'm at a club that ain't paying me for this right now.
Right. So if you go to that spot, right, and let's say you in there, you doing your thing.
That's not entertaining. That's not acting.
But listen, though. You in there, pick it. And the nigga walk up like, hey, man, it's $10 million right here in this suitcase. I want you to kiss me.
So I ain't going to lie to you. In that moment, I probably smacked the shit out of him.
He got the $10 million in the suitcase?
Bro, you don't come out. You think, first of all, what?
How much did he got to pay you to play a song?
All I'm saying is, that's different.
How much did he got to pay to play a song?
That's different.
I'm asking questions.
He not the DJ.
I'm not the DJ, first of all. But you give me $100, I'll probably get a play for you.
You play the song, right? So look, you gonna smack a nigga that got $10 million?
It's not that.
How long is the kiss?
Nah, it's not. It's not about. Nah, fuck that. Y'all got the game fucked up.
Is this a peck or is that tongue action?
Nah,
we ain't going out like that.
No tongue, but no peck though.
Nah, fuck that.
Wait a minute, no tongue, but it's a little bit.
The high school kiss.
So we saying three. We saying five.
Middle school kiss.
Yeah, just hold.
We just like.
You gotta hold.
Oh, give me that 10. What's wrong with y'all niggas? I'm
gonna smack the shit out of both of y'all niggas. Let me tell you why. First
y'all
of all,
niggas,
it
bugging.
Ain't about. So for me,
we
in respect, I might sound crazy.
We bugging.
For me, it ain't
for
about
$10 million.
No,
you said $10 million.
Hear what I'm saying?
Because you're trying to exit the bag out of it.
Hear what I'm saying? Hear what I'm saying. If a nigga walk up to me and think he can ask me to give me some money to do something out of the ordinary, then you must look at me as something else. Now that's disrespectful.
That's your pride, man.
Yeah, it is. And I'm going to be the first one to say it. I ain't going to deny it. But if you walk up to me like, yo.
Yo, your insecurities really getting the best of you, my nigga.
Insecurity.
Maybe that nigga finds you attractive.
Bro, that's not an insecurity.
Like, I mean, but at the same time, how is it different? If the dude is gay, obviously, and he finds you attractive.
That's not insecurity.
And for all of him, the only thing he wants that week, because he's Jeff Bezos. All right,
so let me ask you something. If a nigga came up to you and be like, y'all got $10 million to kiss your girlfriend, you going to let him do it?
To kiss my girlfriend?
Is my girl cool with it? Let's go.
I'm going to go have a conversation with her. I'm
going to smack the shit out that nigga. Bro, why would you ever think you could just come up to me? Yo, cool. I'm not. Yo, $10 million aside, bro. If you come to me and you ask me to do something to my girlfriend, so you really think that I'm.
I respect you because most niggas going to go behind your back and try to do
this. Man, listen.
That's real,
nigga. Because
instead of going behind your back, he's making an offer.
Has anybody ever tried to holler at one of y'all's girls?
It happens.
It happens, right?
It happens, bro.
So you want to respect a nigga that's going to be like, hey, look, man, I find your woman real attractive. I got $10 million right here for you. Just let me.
That nigga suck my dick. I'm going to punch him dead in his fucking nose.
You know what I mean? Like,
are you serious? So you think that's okay? A nigga come and offer you money?
I respect that more than you doing it behind my back.
Bro,
or trying to be sneaky.
Bro, if you do it behind my back, I don't know. You don't give a fuck. Now you
don't
try to.
Know, all right,
here we go. I'm sorry. Let me repaint the picture. A nigga come up to you like this. Yo, I got $10 million.
Oh,
that's different.
That's the last word.
See, that's what I'm talking about. That's different.
That's the last word.
I'm talking on social media.
But I'm talking about.
A nigga come to you record like, I got $10 million to kiss your bitch.
I'm thinking you talk about the movie, because that was a movie where a nigga offered his new wife $1 million to sleep with her, and they took it and it almost destroyed their marriage. But it's because of the insecurities between the husband and wife. It wasn't nothing that the millionaire was doing.
Don't come out to me asking me nothing about who I'm with. Period.
Damn.
Don't do that.
Damn.
That sounds like some feminine ways you got.
It might be, and I'm okay with it. Hey, fuck is you talking about?
Talking
about feminine. Yo,
I'm taking.
So you tell me if a nigga come up to you, bro?
You can kill my girl for $10 million.
Yo, I'm not saying. I'm not saying that it can't happen.
Yo,
let's
clear this up. As long as your girl is okay.
As long as she's okay with it. Absolutely.
As long as she's okay.
Like, you present that to me, I'm going to be like, look, let me go talk to her real quick.
Right, exactly.
Yo, it's going to be a persuasive conversation.
Let me tell you, every woman I've ever dated, we've had this discussion. Look, babe, look, how do you feel about this? Because if somebody offers me some money for you, I need to know how to handle this shit.
Oh, so you're
like,
a pimp.
You know, I'm not a pimp.
Shout out to
However,
pimps.
I don't want to be broke for the rest of my life.
That's all
so
I'm saying.
So if somebody come to me with millions, we're not talking about 10 grand. We ain't talking about 20 grand. We talking about millions.
I've done a lot of work, and I haven't like amassed $10 million, so I feel like this is a great opportunity to get that.
Facts.
You know, like, the easy way out.
Right. Yeah.
All I'm saying is, man, fuck all that, man.
Change the subject.
Where do we draw the line at, like, niggas are willing to do anything for money?
There are niggas who are willing to do anything for money. I'm not one of those niggas.
I ain't one of them niggas.
I'll do a lot for money, but I just.
But you want to let a nigga fuck your bitch for money?
I said that I would have that conversation. I would discuss with her. Like, baby, look.
All right, let me ask you this question. Let me switch it up.
But she probably won't be my bitch after.
So if niggas came to you with the pack and was like, it's a brick, you know, it's $100,000. I need you to go out on this block and serve.
I ain't doing that.
Crack cocaine.
Nah.
You gonna make $100,000 in 1 week.
Nah, fuck no.
Nah, you're not doing that even?
Nah, not
you're
that.
A good guy, man.
I'm not a good bro. I'm not.
Will the cops be around?
No. Guaranteed you're not gonna get locked up.
Fuck yeah. That's a different scenario.
You serving people in the community you grazed up.
Oh my God.
That's fine. I'm gonna get my $100,000. I'm gonna move.
Yo, you selfish motherfucker.
I'm gonna move. I'm gonna go somewhere
else.
So
as long as your girlfriend not the one getting fucked up out of the situation, you don't give a fuck about people.
If she wants to purchase crack, I will serve her.
So listen, since you're having that conversation, Some crackheads do more injustice when they don't have a crack. Ask a crackhead, withdrawals real.
Not even that, when they don't have it, they gotta go steal to get some sort of, you know what I mean?
Yeah, like, bro.
But if you allow them to get past that withdrawal section, they can live a better life.
Hey, if you come to me with a brick, $100,000, I guarantee no jail time. Man, come get your. Hey, I'm Jay Hill, and I'm your neighborhood crack dealer.
If I got a brick, you can get your fix. Put that shit on a shirt, nigga. If I got the brick, you can get your fix.
We splitting the funds 50-50.
And that.
All right, so let me ask you this question.
All right.
What's the biggest income stream for you?
The biggest income stream for me is colleges.
Wow. Okay, personal appearances.
No.
Yes.
Hosting step shows?
Step shows, comedy shows.
Bro, let's talk about that for a second.
Let's talk about that. Let's talk about that.
See, I know you on a much larger scale.
Thank you.
So look, I never forget, right? I started hosting. And I'm like, you know, I want my first show. I mean, I ain't really doing this until I get paid $1,000, right? Mm. I paid $1,000. I'm like, all right, bet. So then I got paid $2,500. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking I'm the shit. These niggas pay hosts $5,000 to $10,000.
It's ridiculous. I'm not surprised. My biggest gig has only been like $5,000. You know what I mean?
That's
like
a lot of money, bro.
It's a lot.
That's rent. That's rent and some more shit.
Oh, it's definitely rent and some more shit. And it's easy as fuck. It goes back to the whole set shit. You know what I mean? If I got to do a step show in Mississippi, I can do the same set in Arkansas, Texas, Alabama, Ohio, wherever. You know what I mean? Right. So, and I've done at least like 200 schools. You know what I mean? So
200 times 5K.
There you go. Do the math.
But I don't. Some schools hit up. Get the you same know what I mean? Like yeah. There might be some schools that's like 30 minutes from Atlanta. Like, hey, we have a budget of $750. I'm pulling up.
Facts.
On a Wednesday, nigga. You know what I mean? I need that $750. You know what I mean? So it just depends. It all depends on where I'm at in life.
How do you deal with like managing your money? Because I'm pretty sure it's a period of time where like step shows is lit. Like from September to November, you know what I'm saying? But then January to fucking. How do you deal with managing your money in those times?
I'm one of them niggas, I pay my rent early. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like rent is the biggest portion of everybody's budget. You know what I mean? So, like.
Rent, insurance, car note.
Yep. So, if I get a large sum of money, I'm going to go ahead and just pay off my rent for like 3-4 months.
Okay.
Just to not even have to worry about that shit.
Right.
And I know I got more income coming in. You know what I mean? So, social media money is cool. Like. You can monetize on Facebook. You can monetize on YouTube, but I don't be fucking with YouTube, right? I don't know. I'm fuck with YouTube, but
they raping niggas, bro.
They raping niggas, and it's like, so a lot of money I make on Instagram is from like businesses hit me up to promote their products. Like motherfuckers hit me up to make jingles or just include their product in a skit. Mm. Right now, gaming. If niggas ain't fucking with gaming, I don't know if y'all fuck with Call of Duty.
But that shit is crazy.
Twitch
is lit.
Twitch is motherfucking lit. T-Pain on Twitch. I can't imagine how much money he makes, but like niggas really pay to watch you play the game. Like,
yeah.
I just started doing that shit like maybe like 3 months ago. I got my first check. It was $250. But
that's not bad.
It's niggas on there to make $50,000 a month.
So give me some free game, man. $1 million free game. Shout out to them.
I would say the free game I would give him is it don't matter if they rape me on YouTube, you still need to be in that space.
No, absolutely.
If not, somebody's going to take your content and put it in that space.
They are, but it's so many rules. Like, you can't. Yeah. I make parodies. Like, that's my, like, I'm the black Weird Al Yankovic is what I consider myself.
No, that's deep.
That's deep.
Shout out to you for that.
Yeah, you know, I'm Bank Shot, you know, Weird Al Yankovic. I call myself Bankovic.
I like that.
Yeah, see that? That was a little. But. You can't use certain, like, instrumentals and shit. They flag your shit. Or you can't monetize on it. You know what I mean? Even on Instagram, like, you go to put some shit up, they'll take it down because somebody done copyrighted the shit. So it's, like, a lot that goes into it, man. So that's why I don't fuck with YouTube.
So for creatives, back into this interview mode, right? How do you set up your pricing for people that that reach out to you to promote their products?
I'm a very big, what's your budget, nigga?
Of course. But how do you set up your price? Because at the end of the day, you got to have a standard.
I do have a standard.
You do the penny for follower thing, like penny times follower? Because I know some people do that.
There was some shit called Social Blue Book, like Kelly Blue Book, I think it was, where like you like, it gives you like an estimate on what your car is worth. You put in information.
Oh, yeah.
So they got that Social Blue Book where you put in your information and it tells you like what you should charge based on.
Okay.
What your following is, the impact, interactivity.
And all that shit, you know what I mean? So
that's still a thing because I'm going to have to check that out.
It's still a thing. It used to be free, but now they charge you to use their like platform. But it ain't a lot, but like you can still use it though. Mm. But like if a motherfucker want me to do like shit, if somebody want me to put like a drink or a t-shirt or some shit in my video, it's $1,000. And that's me dedicating the whole entire shit to your brand. Now, if you just want me to wear your shit and I don't gotta mention it, I'm gonna do like $250 on some. I'm just wearing your shirt, nigga, for, you know, $250 type shit. You know
right,
what I mean?
Right.
And I might be on the low end. You know what I mean? I don't know what other niggas charge, but that's just my pricing for my shit.
If it works for you, it works for you.
Like, yeah,
you
know yeah, what I'm saying? You know what
it's
mean?
Not even
like
about.
Like I said, it also depends on where I'm at in life. You know what I mean?
Shit. That's a fact.
Where you at tonight, bro? Opera.
Tonight, no, I was at Opera last night, man. Shout out to Opera, man.
Man,
shout
that
out
was
to
last him. Night?
Yeah, man, it got wild, man. I'm kind of disappointed, though, because, like, the nigga told me that the bottles was $400, and then I checked my...
A nigga what?
The nigga told me the
bottles is four.
Wait, so you had to pay for your own bottles and you was hosting? Oh, wait, no. Talk to me.
Yeah, I'm like, that's disrespectful.
I got a free bottle. Like, they gave me a bottle, you know what I mean? They paid me some money and shit, so that was cool. But it was people in my section. I ain't know these motherfuckers, but I'm real big on
making sure. Are you recording right now?
Yep.
Why are you recording?
Because I'm like that. And I've been drinking. I'm feeling good right now.
No, like you want to give away the fucking shit.
Hold on,
shit.
You want me to record you too?
No, like turn that shit off, man.
But I'm real big on making sure everybody has a good time. You know what I mean? And it's also like, bro, being like popular is a gift and a curse.
Talk about it.
Because you have to.
You got to recognize everybody recognize you. Like, I don't know you. I'm sorry if you know me.
That part. But you also have to like live up to like a certain image.
Facts.
You know what I mean? So it's like.
Yeah, you gotta have the bottle.
You know, exactly.
Man, you gotta pay for that. I need a comp and you need to pay for the bottle that I'm trying to buy.
Yeah, they
gave me one bottle.
They the rappers, they pay them and they give them money to throw out to the strippers.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
See?
That's a fact.
So you mean to tell me you bought a bottle?
I bought a bottle.
Out of your fucking.
Out of my check that I got.
So you lost money.
I did not lose money. But I was pissed off because my bank statement said a little more than what the bottle cost.
Man, the goal is to make money. I ain't gonna lie to you.
No,
so
facts.
I'm gonna be in that motherfucker sober before I'm a cheap one. I'll be at the mic.
That's facts.
Yo,
that's facts. But then niggas ain't gonna invite you back.
Shit.
If you ain't spending money. I've experienced
that's
before,
their fault.
Man. It's... No,
hey, man, he teaching you finesse game for him.
I'm just saying, like,
that's
niggas,
his thing.
Like, I don't go out. I don't go out because niggas aren't going to pay somebody to come out who's always out. Like, why am I going to pay Mr. Banks to come out if I can catch a nigga Thursday and Facts. Friday at Opera? You know what I mean? So it's like, I don't go out. But
how was the experience for you?
Oh, it was lit. It was lit. Last night was the first night that I ever had, like, they brought the sign, like, welcome bank shot. That was the first time I ever experienced that shit. That shit was lit. I'm pissed off, though, because it was some nigga who was standing in the way of the sign. So it fucked up my Instagram video. Nigga head big as fuck, blocking all the letters. I said, nigga, if you don't get the fuck out the way. But it was dope, you know what I mean? But tonight, I'm at Bar Code tonight.
Bar in D.C.?
In D.C.
Oh, y'all lit like that.
I never been there before.
It's going to be like that.
I'm in your entourage tonight, my nigga.
You on a Bar Code?
No, I'm just saying, I want to roll with you.
Come through, please.
I want that celebrity. I'm with him.
He probably needs some company.
You want me to be your security?
Can you, please?
Nigga, I have no problem with punching niggas. Like,
thank you.
Zero problem.
Nah, he probably needs some company, bro.
No.
Yo, stop, pause.
Yeah, yeah.
No, not like that.
No, it's just the way you said it. And then you was like, in your phone, you ain't even looking at a nigga.
I was looking for somebody because I was
speaking. He probably needs some company.
I was trying to do the shout out, but I couldn't find it.
He's different.
So was it like, have you seen the, shout out to.
Yeah, District Cosmo. Casamigos, I fuck with that shit.
Right? Yeah. You seen what's his name? Justin LaBoy, right?
Oh shit!
He came to DC and he was like, "DC is fucking lit." He like, man, DC is the district of Casamigos.
I don't like DC.
You don't?
We just have a moment.
DC
okay,
for
ahead.
Me stands for don't come.
Why? Why?
Dangerous civilians. drive carefully. You know, it's just nigga.
Why you in DC,
bro? It's just nigga. The traffic. Like I'm in Atlanta,
yeah,
bro.
It is crazy.
The traffic in Atlanta is fucking crazy.
The traffic in Atlanta is crazy just because it's a lot of people. But like y'all streets and shit is
little as fuck,
yeah. Narrow, and y'all got hella one ways. And then yeah. Y'all streets is one letter. Like nigga, K
and
Street.
And they got a million meters, nigga.
That's
like
what I'm saying,
they
bro.
Got a meter and a nigga driveway. Man. Like how the fuck. You got a meter in the nigga driveway.
So you ain't even witnessed the parking yet.
Nigga, I have. I'm parking at my hotel and I had to pay $72 for 2 days, nigga.
See, no, I ain't even talking about that. I'm talking about the headache of not even finding parking. Like,
oh, no, I Ubered last night where I was going for multiple
reasons. So you really don't like DC?
I mean, I don't like the traffic. Oh, I don't like God. The traffic. But the love be real, though. Like, this is my third time to DC. I came when I was younger. I checked out the monuments and shit. And then I did a step show at George Mason, and then this is my third time out.
I'm just like, no, that's gonna be the clip. They're gonna run with that. You don't like DC?
That's don't come.
Shout out to Deuce Two Times. That's what it is. Deuce Two Times. D Grant, District of Casamigos, Hey, he got it from the sand from Justin LaBoy. Is that how we say it? Justin LaBoy or Justin LA Boy?
Justin LaBoy is toxic.
Shout out to Spanish niggas getting money with Puff.
Women right, don't
pass
listen.
That Villon.
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 Yo, let's take one more drink, man. We out, man. Appreciate y'all, go. Man. We done?
No, we're not done. I'm trying to pour another one so we can get to the next phase. Nigga.
Women don't listen to Justin LaBoy. He sets unrealistic expectations. I'm not sending you $1,500 for your nails.
Your nails don't even cost $1,500.
But you're supposed to send $1,500
for your nails. Well, cost
I'm not sending $1,500.
$70 at max. And a lot of these hoes ain't getting fucking.
Oh boy,
what is it called? Acrylic? What the fuck is it called?
We went from I don't even know.
What is it called?
Yeah, this is elevating.
Yeah,
we really from what's the shit that's $70? The gel.
Okay,
that's what it is. A lot of these girls ain't even getting gel.
So off of that, how are you managing?
Full of shit. You ain't getting gel.
How are you?
Your nails is $40.
No,
you ain't
facts.
Getting gel.
Facts.
This guy is really.
You ain't getting tips. You ain't getting gel. You basic. Your shit $40.
Wow.
So how are you managing the influx of, you know what I'm saying, attention from the women? Like, is it you?
Are you okay?
You know what's so funny?
I asked about him and his hoes.
That's okay. Yeah.
We have a conversation, old sensitive ass.
I still got
a little. Drink your shit.
But this that's is my second
you,
one.
Yo, come this on. Nigga is feeling it right now. Yo, you in a good space right
I'm
now.
I'm in a great space.
That's good. That's good.
Yeah, he's because
I need you to go to work and really turn up because that's how you get paid.
I'm definitely turning up.
He said, hey, man, Bancho, you got bitch tendencies. Would you kiss a nigga? Did you kiss a nigga for $30?
Yeah, it's crazy the evolution of the conversation. I'm just trying to know how he managed the women that he got. Because I'm like, we about to be there. I'm about to be famous in a few, so I'm just trying to understand how do I need to manage.
So look, man,
from the OG, like
I don't have hoes.
What you mean? You know they ain't a DM.
What they
stop playing, bro.
Bro.
Nah, I get it. They not hoes. They not called hoes.
My bad.
Like,
they're interested.
I don't have a lot of women in
interns.
My DMs.
Is that what you call them? Interns?
No, not even that. You know what I mean? I prefer to be like a one lady nigga.
That's dope.
Okay.
You know
okay.
what I mean? Like, I prefer that.
So you have one lady right now.
So you got a
girlfriend. I'm not saying that.
So you out here single.
This is like the first span of me being single, like, you know, in a while.
Okay, so you single out here.
Yeah.
The DMs is, name. It's not a flood, but
it's not a flood.
It's a nice moisting.
Moisting.
The ones who in my DMs, I don't want them.
Facts.
You don't want them. Oh, they just big girls.
Damn.
Hey, yo, what's wrong with
damn.
You? It's about me.
I fucked a lot of big girls in my time. You probably ain't never touched a big bitch in your life.
Shout out to big girls.
Stop.
I've been with a big girl, fucked
the shit out of a bunch of ugly ass big bitches.
Yeah.
You ain't that shit.
Nah, I fucked a big girl, but she wasn't ugly.
Some ugly bitches in my time.
She was a pretty big girl.
Fuck out of here.
You know. She was a pretty big girl, not pretty big.
I can say what I want. The big bitches will be like, yeah, he really fucked the shit out of
her. She's a pretty big
girl. No, she's not pretty big. She was like
pretty and big. Okay.
Pretty and big.
Yo, we getting canceled. What the fuck is going on?
This is the last time you're going to see me. All my events are going to be canceled after this. You know what I mean?
I respect you for that.
Shout out to big girls.
At least you kept it pretty in the face.
You feel me? But, you know, I hope this is worth it. At the end of the day, like, if I get canceled, at least I have some Villon. Shout out to Villon.
Shout out to Villon.
In the building right now. We got Cognac, liqueur, villain.
Hey, yo, I don't think they want to be a part of this shit. Get like, my shit off right now.
You gotta
nigga,
be
you might have to blur this shit.
Yeah, this nigga, blur my face out, please. Nigga,
yo, I'm weak because the nigga said, I had some
God
pretty
good
girls.
What's the DJ Expo? That's the nigga name that was at the shit tonight?
Yeah.
Hey, shout out to him. We did a show together at Virginia State, and then tonight on stage, he called me Buckshot.
Yo.
I said, who the fuck is that?
The disrespect is real.
Have you ever had. Have you ever had anybody ask you for help for a set and then didn't show you the love that you think you deserve?
Ask me for love?
Hell no.
Ask
help.
Me help. Yes.
I shouldn't have asked you this.
Yes.
Because I ain't going to say no names, but
no, yes.
I've had popular niggas ask me for help for shows.
Yeah.
And I feel like I didn't get the love that I deserve.
What were you expecting? And what did you get?
At least just show me the same love that you used to show me. That's it.
I'm real big on the barter. I'm real big on the bartering system. You know what I mean? Like
meaning that, like, did they supposed
like
to kick
for example,
you something?
For example, Bank Shot showed us love, right?
Right.
He pulled up and he had shows. He got to go to a show right after this, right?
Facts.
He just finished hosting the show. He had to pull up. So I don't know if I happen to get an opportunity, niggas change positions every day.
Right.
Let's say, hypothetically, I get 600,000 followers, right? I would definitely show him love.
Not even that. Like, let's say I did a favor for you. And then let's say I got a show out here in D.C. And I'm like, hey, Jay, can you post this on your page?
Yeah.
That's the type of shit I would be looking for. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Let me tell you, Jay's not going to do it. But I would post it.
I'll put somewhere to stay, I think. You sure? I said I got a spot. You don't got to get a hotel.
That's different. We talking about your page. Now, you'll fucking shoot somebody for hitting him. But, like, he's specific about that page.
Yeah, I know. He only has 74 posts. I've seen it.
Yeah. He be super specific about it. Now, Jay will do anything for
you. You got to protect your brand. Yeah. You don't got to be in your page. You put in your story. You know what I mean?
I'm going to look out for you regardless, bro.
Something. But even that, you can take it down. After the show is over, take it down.
Yeah. I mean, you should do that anyway. Like, what the fuck? You don't need all that old shit on your page?
No, yeah.
I've definitely, like, I have helped people. Yo, I've had somebody, like, wow. It was a specific artist that put up to one of my podcasts. He didn't want to be on camera, none of that. And I asked him for an interview, and he said I had to hit the label up, and now I'm seeing him doing interviews and freestyles and shit. I'm like, yo, bro, what the fuck? Like, I don't fuck with it. I think Charlamagne talked about this. Charlamagne was like, yo, I feel like people just don't respect black media, right? And it's like, I feel like a lot of people don't respect independent media, right? Everybody always want this look, and they want to go to these people because who's hot?
Yeah.
Yo, you're hot. You're making them hot. So if you come fuck with me, make me hot, nigga. I'm independent. You paying another nigga that ain't even, bro, like you fucking with somebody that got a job under somebody else. I'm doing this by myself. Yeah. You feel me? Like, exactly. And that's what I don't want to fuck with. And a lot of times, I don't be wanting to say nothing because I don't want to come off as a hater.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
you can't say shit without being a hater. You can't say shit,
bro.
Nigga.
When I was watching this one nigga, bro, and like, he just dropped a series of things, and I'm like, yo, he just was in my living room, bro. Swear to God in my life. Mm. I ain't post no pictures. I got a picture of him and all that, but just out of respect because he ain't want no pictures. But I'm like, yo, I hit him on
you're gonna back, get a
like,
call.
Yo, like, bro, like, can you do an interview with me or a freestyle or whatever? No answer. At first, he was like, yo, I gotta talk to the label because the label. I hate niggas like that.
I was trying to do a celebrity kickball game for my birthday. My birthday, August 7th, right? Nigga Roscoe Dash. He lives in Atlanta, nigga. We got cool. We follow each other on Instagram, and then like I used to play Madden a lot. We was in like this Madden League, blah blah blah. So I hit the nigga up like, hey man, I'd like for you to be a part of the kickball shit. Now I'm not gonna pay nobody to come out and kick it, but he was like, yeah, I'll come for free, but you gotta pay my management to come through. It's $500. He was no longer invited to come to the kickball game. Because I'm not paying $500 for your management, nigga. I don't want your management there, nigga. I just need you there. You know what I mean? So.
And a lot of times what happens is niggas, I ain't gonna lie to you, niggas get caught up in the response, right? Because what happens is, and what I mean by that is, now he really want the $500, but he don't want to be the mean guy. That's why we got managers, right?
Yeah.
But he already saw it.
Yeah. So he had to say something. Yeah. I do that a lot too. I play my manager. Like, niggas hit me up like, hey, oh, this is so and so. Like, nigga, because niggas respect your manager more than they respect the artist.
Yeah, but that you don't want to be the bad guy either, though.
You don't want to be the bad guy, but I also don't care because I am a Villone. Shout out to Villone for the
Villone.
Cognac, Villone.
Shout out to Villone because this really got this nigga talking the truth tonight, boy. He went out here and said some shit. I'm like, oh shit.
Man, I'm good.
Yeah, man. You got to be careful,
and
man.
I think it's the important. That's why it's so important to have your own, bro. Keep it on. Like, even I know we joking a lot tonight, but like, yo, like, ownership is so important because like, we can get on platforms and talk what we can be who we want to be.
Exactly.
Right? And
we can all be blacklisted together.
Right, but not even blacklisted, though. Like,
no, we're going to be after this.
Right.
Not that, though, because I feel like a lot of times people, like, the internet is the internet.
Cancel culture is real.
Yeah, if you don't listen to somebody and what they saying, of course you can cancel them for 5 seconds of what you hear, right?
Mm.
But it is what it is. I feel like, for me, I know who I am. My peoples know who I am. So, like, even throughout the jokes, I just feel like if you mean well, you always going to be well, right? No matter what nobody else think. And I feel like that's the importance of having your own. Because what happens is we can make a mistake on somebody else's platform and can't come back because they're going to get us the fuck out of the way.
Facts. But I feel like, I think the other concern of that is like, you have morals and you got a code. You know what I'm saying?
Always.
So people fuck with you because you a stand-up dude. You know what I mean? Beyond all the other shit, the antics and all that.
But a minute clip,
a lot of niggas, antics, but they ain't got no code. They ain't got no morals.
But from a minute clip, a new listener might not even be able to get a chance to see the morals and ethics because they seen a minute clip that went viral and we be talking some ignorant shit.
But your elevation in the game ain't got nothing to do with the audience for real. It's going to be about the relationships and the networking.
Like, if you post that clip of me saying I don't like DC,
I'm definitely posting that.
I'm never going to be invited back.
No, don't let me feel bad. Come on, bro.
But I said
you gonna be invited back.
I just don't like the traffic, but you gonna post it where I said I don't like it. So it's like that's,
bro,
that's
don't make me feel.
They
bad.
Gonna take the minute clip, and that's what they're gonna run with.
The question is, are we getting invited to this celebrity kickball game? Like that's all I want to know.
In Ohio,
yo,
no, it's in Atlanta, but it's
yo, Jay Hill can play kickball. Look at that nigga, he physically fit.
Nah,
he physically.
You say you play sports. What you play?
Football.
Oh, well,
nigga, it's just like that.
Hey, corner.
Corner. I about to say corner. I play safety.
I'm corner your ass. I'm kicking the kickball.
Corner, football. I don't think it's the same thing.
Bro, all you got to do is just kick the ball.
Just come hang around celebrities. Yo, you going to have some ribs, right?
What?
No, it's not going to be no ribs.
It's going to be.
The fuck is going on? Don't tell me this is like one of them new age vegan.
What?
It was going to be food trucks and shit that was going to pull up. I'm not having it no more, though, man. Because niggas be lying.
What you mean?
Like, if motherfuckers confirm, have you ever had somebody confirm some shit and then last minute they got something that came up?
Unexpected? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't want to go through that.
Is it that or is it your pride and your ego?
It's I know niggas. And
he doesn't want to take a risk with so many people to try to make something happen.
First of all, it's my birthday.
Okay.
So I don't want to have to August 7th.
Let's
Leo?
Go.
Leo gang.
Okay. My daughter's a
no
Leo.
Other sign can spell out that shit.
I can't. Yeah, you're right about that.
That was the corniest you ever seen. Zach.
Wow. That's corny.
I respect you, my nigga.
What are you?
What I'm a Gemini.
You
Gemini.
Can't spell your shit out. That's what I'm saying. That's why you upset. No, you gotta use two hands. No, nigga. You can't. You can't do the end. The end is fucking it up, nigga.
You spelled it. Do it.
No,
what the fuck?
Leo, nigga.
You specialize in sign language?
That's not. That's. I don't think that's E in sign language. I don't know if that's E. I don't.
Yo, this
don't
is
know.
Terrible, bro.
This is horrible. This is horrible.
Shit. But yo, you see why we call it? You might not. Like
I might not,
this.
Like,
might not
this
like this podcast. But
yo, hey. So wait a minute. You just scared that on your birthday niggas ain't gonna come through?
No, it's not even that. It's like first of all, it's my birthday, so I don't feel like I should have to do a lot of work. I gotta put the like. I gotta make the
I got
roster.
You.
I gotta get jerseys for niggas.
So
I gotta
why
reach
you
out
ain't just get somebody
shit.
To manage the event for you?
I don't trust niggas.
Facts.
Niggas will let you down every time. Man.
That's what people don't understand, bro. Like
it's hard to trust niggas, bro.
Because a nigga got 500,000, a million followers, bro. Niggas is still real niggas at the end of the day, bro.
I don't
like,
trust niggas, bro.
You gotta understand, like niggas is still like us grinding.
I've had niggas who like were like my manager, quote unquote. Let's say like, and I had a show. This nigga, I get to the airport and shit. This nigga booked my flight for the following weekend.
Fuck
that
up.
Type shit. Like, little shit like that. Like, nigga, I can fuck up my own. So, like, nigga, what do I need you for? You know what I mean? Right. Or I had niggas hit me up like, hey, I want to manage you. I need to get a percentage of all your deals. And it's like, nigga, if niggas hit me up directly.
Well, that's different.
It ain't different.
That's different.
Because,
that's different.
It ain't different because... If you want to manage me, if you coming to me, nigga, you go out and work deals, yeah, you get a percentage of that. But,
so
like, my regular shit.
I thought that too at one point in time. I swear I was thinking the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
But
give me some game, man.
So when it comes to that, right, you got a manager and they're working for you in a sense. So there's a lot of things that they're doing that they're not getting paid for. So right. What happens is that's kind of like an integrity thing. So it's like now, if you do have somebody that's hitting you up for the things that I didn't get paid for, I should be able to get paid for that. It's just
I disagree because there's a lot of things that I do that I don't get paid for.
I mean, so?
But you're doing it for yourself,
right.
Bro. So, like, and you talking about a real, I'm talking about a real manager.
Okay.
We're not talking about these fake ass niggas that's trying to come up.
Okay.
A real manager really is dedicating their life to you. Like,
I've never had nobody do that, though. Their life, your everything becomes their number one priority. I need one of them.
So, like, those type of people... You don't talk to people anymore. They talk to them because
yeah,
it's so
need,
that way.
I need one of those. I've never had one of those, and I think that's the issue. I remember I had this one nigga tell me he wanted to manage me, and I was like, "Yeah, send me over to like the contract." This nigga sent me an email. Like, it wasn't even an attachment. It was just
it was just a bunch of words in the email. Yeah, that sucks.
Oh.
No.
Yeah, man, it was.
No.
Hey, but man, what time is it, man? We gotta get.
Oh shit, we had 1 hour and 14 minutes. My
yeah, let's get the.
It's been an hour
and 14 minutes on the pod. Yeah. It says
damn.
It right here on the screen.
Yeah,
thank
God.
Oh, yeah, man. We gotta stop it. We can go.
Let's get the fuck out of
man,
here.
Man, you a fun ass person to be around, man. I
hey,
appreciate
man.
You
no,
coming
I appreciate
on the show,
y'all
man.
For having me on here, man.
You know what
I definitely
saying?
Appreciate
you
it.
You got
man.
Jay Hill in his bag tonight. I just
hey,
want you to know
hey,
that.
Jay hey, Hill has showed me a side of him that I've never seen before.
I don't know if that's good or bad.
All I want to say is I appreciate you for pulling up, bro, for real. I mean,
absolutely.
That, yo, I feel like niggas definitely gotta keep. Kicking it and just like building for.
Oh yeah, no, bro. We definitely gonna be in.
We coming through Atlanta in a couple of weeks.
Hey,
yo, can we come and get drunk? Like, you know what I'm saying? I'll buy us a cheap bottle. Like, come on, we'll get some Vallone or something like that.
You can get drunk
for
sure.
We're not going to a club. I'm saying we're going to go link up with this nigga.
Especially if we're not going to a club, we're not buying no cheap bottle. That don't make sense.
Yeah, no.
Vallone is $30, nigga. That's a cheap
bottle. I'm not buying no cheap bottle. Why we buy a cheap bottle?
You know what I'm saying.
My one nigga came down from Ohio and we bought a bottle of 1942.
Let's link up and let's have a good
time. In a store, it's not that bad.
No, it's like $200.
How about that? Okay, calm down, Jay. I lived in Atlanta for 10 years. I've never been to that strip club that's downtown, this famous one.
Magic City?
I've never been to Magic City, and I want the lemon pepper wings. So,
Magic City is magic.
I'm actually going to be in Atlanta next weekend, but I want Jay Hill to come. I'm like, we all link up and go out. Like, let's go to Magic City.
What you doing out there?
Actually, a friend of mine is getting an award in radio. He's been doing radio for like 30 years. So, he's getting an award for his time in radio, and he wants me to present him the award. So, I'm flying down to present the award.
Oh, man, that's love, man.
So, you know what I mean? Like I said, I used to live down there, so I got a lot of homies. So, I'm just really going down and kicking with the homies and shit. And
so, fellas, how y'all feel, man? How the V-Long got y'all
feel? This shit is delicious, bro.
V-Long got me gone, but
yeah,
it's strong.
Yeah. It's not real cognac. Y'all need to stop saying that. But this is a delicious
liqueur. It says that, though. I think it says
it needs to stop. Unless it was made in cognac, France, and you should not put the liqueur in there. Like,
40% alcohol. I mean, that's stronger than a beer. So
I mean, but you can put it in some. You can mix it. It mix well.
I ain't really feeling the snake on the sword, though. I ain't really.
You don't like that?
No. Like,
you are a villain.
They give me like serpent, you know, like devil vibes.
Okay. He a Christian guy.
Yeah, I've been tapping in with my.
How's fraternity life, man?
Shout out to God.
Shout out
how's fraternity life.
Fraternity life is great, man. You know, that shit, it kind of get lame once you graduate, though.
Right.
And what's kind of crazy, though, is like, I go back to all these schools, and these niggas ask me to, like, stroll with them, but, like, they done remixed all the strolls that I know, so I don't be knowing, like, and I'm older, nigga, so it's like, that's y'all, you know what I mean? Like,
y'all just went into some fraternity terminology.
Strolling is like, when you ever go to a party, and, like, you see all, like, the motherfucking niggas doing... They dancing.
Okay, got you.
That's called stroll.
So they keep evolving and changing the dances? I thought it was all the same.
It's supposed to be the same. Stuff. Like, majority is the same, but, like, they add a little...
Twinge to it.
2020 to it. You know what I mean? Put a little, you know
that
what
makes
mean?
Sense. I don't know why I would assume that they would do the same things, but I feel you.
You know, that shit started, like, my fraternity started in 1906. Shout out to Alpha Phi Alpha. So it's like, you got to think, from 1906 to 2021, it's going to be... changes within that shit, though.
Last question, I'm going to shut the hell up.
All right.
As a black man who went through the fraternity process and is now a part of it and been a part of it for a long time, would you recommend it to other young black men?
Yes.
Of course.
And can you tell me why? Give us the reason why.
It will teach you just... It's kind of hard to say what I was saying. Like, you'll be humble. For sure. You know what I mean? I mean, I feel like there's other ways that you can... Yeah, humility. You know what I mean? But, like, there's other things you can do in life to where, like, you'd be humble. But, like, to have that just, like... All right, I'll give you a perfect example. So, I knew nothing about fraternities going into college. Like, had no fucking idea. Nobody in my family's Greek. None of that shit. Now, I get booked to host step shows, though, because of my Greek affiliation.
Mm.